Love and happiness are not just random acts or accidents which come along, sweep us up, and then toss us out. Love and happiness are self-generated and contagious. They align to everything within a similar frequency and will expand and grow. Don't shut love out of your life by saying it's impossible to find. The quickest way to receive love is to give love. The fastest way to lose love is to hold it too tightly. And the best way to keep love is to give it wings. Have you ever thought about the meaning of unconditional love? It seems that the love that we parents have for our children is as close to unconditional love as we can get without the help of God's love in our lives. We love our children through good times and bad, and we continue loving them even if they don't meet the expectations we may have for them. We make a choice to love our children even when we consider them unlovable. Our love doesn't stop when we don't feel love for them. This is similar to God's love for us, but the truth is that God's love transcends the human definition of love to a point that is hard to comprehend. The question is, how does God define love? The Bible tells us that God is love, but how can we even begin to understand that truth? There are many passages in the Bible that give us God's definition of love. The most well-known verse might be John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believed in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. So one way God defines love is in the act of giving. However, what God gave us, or should we say, who God gave us, was not a mere gift-wrapped present. God sacrificed his only Son so that we who put our faith in his Son will not spend eternity separated from him. This is an amazing love. I am your host, Christina Plotkin. Thank you for being with us today, and welcome. This is Straight from the Heart.